How you guys doing tonight? Yeah, I'm doing all right. Got jumped last week by a bunch of people. It's a great way to start a conversation, I know. But it happened, so I'm going to talk about it. You know, I posted a lot on Facebook, so I was kind of pissed. All my friends, like, posted a bunch of supportive messages and stuff. And then my mom just commented and said, I'm lighting candles, then they all die. All my friends are offering me legal advice. My mom's just out here casting spells. Ancient Sicilian curses. That's how she is though, old school Italian. She has all of her phone calls with me by saying, you know, one day I'll be dead, then you know. And I'll do what? Something, apparently, I don't really know. But I mean, aside from getting jumped, things have been pretty good for me lately, you know? Got a new apartment, that's cool. My new apartment though, when I'm sitting outside smoking cigarettes, this guy will always bother me, and I hate him. One day, I'm sitting in my backyard, minding my own business, and he just strolls into my backyard. This is how I know I have some level of social anxiety, because as soon as I see him, my first thought is, why is this man in my backyard? My first thought is, I don't want to talk to this guy right now. And he comes up and he's like, you smoke weed? I'm like, not anymore. He's like, you coke? I'm like, sometimes. So he busts out the crack pipe, and he begins to smoke crack in front of me. And he's like, hey man, you want some? I can't, I got a drug test coming up, which isn't true. I don't know why I felt like I had to give this guy a valid excuse, like, oh, what, you just don't want some more crack to you right now? I don't buy it. But folks, his response to this was the greatest thing I've ever heard. He just goes, come on, man, it's Saturday. Because you all know Saturdays, smoking crack, that's right. You don't know that. But yeah, I made a lot of changes, new job, went to the gym once, that was cool. Couldn't really do it though, it wasn't so much that working out was hard, it's more so the sheer amount of old men's dicks you'll see in the locker rooms of some of these gyms when you're changing. Yeah, no, it's real, it's a problem. This one guy put me really over the edge. I'm sitting there, you know, I'm getting all pumped up to work out, and it's just dangling there in front of me. The oldest dick I've ever seen. This man was like 50 or 60, his dick was 102. And I picked up my stuff and I left. And I haven't been back to the gym since. I feel like when I die in about 20, 30 years from being so out of shape, I don't know what that dick's fault. Shoulders on my bike top. I don't know, I'm kind of fat. I don't really like telling fat jokes though. Like, part of me feels like if I don't mention it, maybe you won't notice. But I'm always like kind of chubby and I'm really good at sport. Like, the only way I can compete in the Olympics is if they introduce a new category called competitive depression. I can make fun of those fat guys, it's okay. And she didn't agree, but I feel like there's like a brotherhood there. Like, if I make fun of a fat guy, like at the end of the day, we're both gonna be in the same Chinese buffet trying to see how long we can stay before they kick us out. So I think we're in this together, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, if I want to lose weight, she'll probably stop drinking so much. I don't really feel like to drink. Way out of hand, you know what I mean? I think my story is a few years ago, my buddy called me, he's like, I got this party going, like, you gotta come, there's these girls that are gonna be there, one of them I feel like you could hit it off with, like, you gotta come to this party. And I wasn't sure if I wanted to go, I was kind of sick, I had like the stomach bug, so I was like, I don't know if I should go, but I figured, you know, I'll probably go and drink a little bit and be okay. So I go there and instantly just start pounding shots to calm the nerves. And I started to notice that I'm feeling more sick. My idea is, maybe if I drink more, it'll numb the sickness. And so at a certain point in the night, I am trashed. And these girls finally arrive. As soon as I see them, I leap from my chair and I yell, you're here! And I run towards them. And I jump in the air and perform this aerial twirl. And mid-air, I shit my pants and black out. Now, yeah. And I feel like it's very important to view this from their perspective. Like, oh, maybe we'll go check out this party. Maybe it'll be fun. As soon as they walk in, this very large drunken man, they do not know, charges at them, and performs his weird pirouette where he proceeds to shit his pants and maybe die. It's not exactly the best first impression, you guys. But plot twist, didn't get laid that night, so. That's a goddamn lie. I love the girl that introduced all this to me one of them just turns to the friend like, hey, I called dibs on that dude who shit himself. That's what I'm on. It's not how it works at all. Yeah, I drink a little bit. When I get drunk, I do this weird thing. I'll write like joke ideas on my phone that I think are funny. I'll wake up in the morning, they're all just ridiculous. And I like to do a thing at the end of my set where I read off a couple of these weird drunk jokes. Are you guys interested in hearing something?
Yeah!
I'll just write it off a couple later. This one just says, instead of it's raining men, how about cloudy for the chance of men? That one's hilarious, you guys should look at that. This next one, no one likes it, but I think it's the greatest achievement of my life. It says, I'm a bigger fan of Snoop Dogg's less successful song, Smoke Weed Certain Days. That deserves a goddamn standing ovation up there, pretty much. Fuck yeah. And then this one, I was in the hospital, and this guy came into the hospital, he had a tattoo down his arm that just said salami in Rastafarian coloring. Like, I don't have a joke for that, but I just need to tell everyone that that happened. It's ridiculous. And like, oh, there's this, something I noticed recently where there's this guy who works with me, he always calls me Boo. I thought, oh, yeah, that's his thing. He's like, hey, Boo. And I thought, yeah, that's normal. But I started to realize that he only called me Boo. Like, he walked by, he's like, what's up, Boo? I'm like, hey, what's up? And so they walk by, he's like, hello, Barbara. Either this guy thinks that's my name, or we're in love. And the last one, and this is my favorite of all. All it says is, Space Jam 2, starring me. I don't get a hearing this in my head of just a bunch of movie executives around a boardroom, like, we're going on Space Jam 2, we're Michael Jordan's too old, what do we do? One of them just stands up like, someone calls Sam LiButti. It's me on the way. Thank you guys, I'm Sam LiButti.